Good morning, students. In the last video, we have learned about noun. Okay, its definition. What is noun and its different types of concrete noun and abstract noun. And in concrete noun, we have seen proper noun. Okay, now we will see the remaining kinds of nouns. Okay. So we start with the common noun. Okay, so what is common noun? Okay, a common noun refers to names of persons, places or things in general. Okay, look at the examples below. Okay, below are some examples. So, which names comes under common noun? Persons. Okay. King, man, woman, mother, father, teacher, nurse, soldier, etc. So, all these names comes under the common noun category. Okay. Because see here. What is here? King. So, here not name of the king is mentioned, means if here instead of king, if there is Akbar or Birbal, okay, so that comes under proper noun, but here only king is mentioned. If the king is mentioned in the sentence, then that comes under the common noun category. Man, so here only man is mentioned, name of that man is not mentioned, that's why it is a common noun. Woman, it is also common noun because name of the woman is not mentioned. Mother, father, okay. Teacher, so here name of teacher is not mentioned. Okay, only teacher category is mentioned. That's why it is a common noun. Nurse, soldier, so here not any name, particular name of that man, woman, okay, or king is not mentioned. That's why these are the common nouns. Name of places like garden, road, school, zoo, hotel, restaurant, etc. So here after reading that, okay, garden, so will you get to know about which garden? Okay, can you understand what is the name of the garden? No. Okay, it may be any garden. So, name of that garden is not mentioned. That's why it is a common noun. Okay, and if the name is mentioned here, then that comes under proper noun. Here, road. So, see here only road is mentioned. Which road is mentioned? No, means Mahatma Gandhi road or any other road. Okay, that is not mentioned. So, it comes under common noun. School. So here only school is mentioned. Okay, so, but which school is mentioned? No, name of the school is not there. That's why particular name of any school is not mentioned. So it is common noun. Zoo, hotel. So only hotel is mentioned. Okay, name of that hotel is not mentioned. So hotel is common noun. And if the name of that hotel is mentioned, then that is the proper noun. Restaurant. So name of the restaurant is not mentioned, only restaurant is mentioned. That's why it is also common noun. Okay, name of animals like dog, lion, cat, etc. So these also comes under common noun. Name of things like book, pen, pencil, chair, table, key, lock, stone, etc. So the name of these things, okay, this also comes under common noun. Okay, here book is mentioned, but which book is mentioned? No, so only book. So book is a common noun. And see here, here is the name of book, Harry Potter. That's why it is a proper noun and it is a common noun. Pen. Which pen is mentioned? means pen of which company is mentioned? No, that's why it is a common noun. Chair, table. So these are not the particular names. Okay, these are names of things. Okay, here you can also mention a cup. Okay, or a glass. Okay, so or a tiffin. So these all are common nouns because there is no mention of the particular name. Okay, only the names of things are there. That's why these also comes under the common noun. So you understood common noun? Common noun is a noun that refers to people or thing in general. Okay, so the third type, okay, we have seen proper noun, common noun. Now we will see collective noun. So write down the definition of collective noun. Okay, a collective noun is the name of a group of persons or things belonging to the same kind. Okay, so collective means collection of some things. Okay, so here collective noun means group of persons of the same kind. Okay, or group of things belonging to the same kind. So in the name itself, we can get the definition of collective noun. Collective means collection, group of same kind of persons or same kind of things. Okay, they are considered as one complete whole. Okay, so whenever we consider as group, then it becomes singular. Okay, so it is a only one word. Okay, so after seeing examples, you will know. Okay, so here is the first example. A swarm of bees. Swarm of bees means group of, okay, bees. So that group is called as swarm. A flock of sheep. So when there are various sheep, okay, then their group is called as flock. So flock is a collective noun. Swarm is a collective noun because it is a group. Okay, group of sheep. A bunch of keys. Bunch of keys means when we collect many keys. Okay, and then what is formed? Bunch. What we call to that group of keys? It is called as bunch. Bunch of keys. So here bunch is a collective noun. A flight of steps. So flight is also group. It is also called as collective noun. A bucket of flowers. Okay, bucket of a bouquet of flowers. Okay, so when there are various flowers we collect, okay, then that is called bouquet. Okay, so group of flowers means bouquet. So here flower is a common noun. Okay, but group of flowers, okay, group of same flowers. Okay, so the bouquet is a collective noun. So here swarm, flock, bunch, flight, bouquet. So all these are groups. So this comes under collective noun. Okay, because collective means collection. Okay, collection of or group of persons or things. So I think you have got collective noun. So we proceed further. The fourth kind is material noun. Okay, so what do you understand by material? Okay, material means from which we can prepare something. Okay, so let's see what is definition of material noun. A material noun is the name of a material from which many things are made. Okay, so from material we make something. Okay, so here names of materials, for example, wood, water, gold, sand, milk, sugar, cotton, wool, etc. So all these are materials, okay? Wood, water, gold. So we prepare something from this. These are materials. So this comes under material noun, okay? And so we have seen what? All the concrete nouns, proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. Now we will see abstract noun. Okay, so what is abstract noun? An abstract noun names an idea or a quality or a state. Okay, an abstract noun cannot be seen, heard, smelled, touched, or tasted. It can only be felt or experienced. Okay, so what we have seen or learned about concrete nouns? Concrete nouns are the names of the places, things, okay, that we can see, hear, smell, touch, and taste. And on opposite side, what are abstract nouns? An abstract noun names an idea or a quality or a state. Okay, an abstract means it is an idea, okay, quality of a person or state of a person, and that cannot be seen, heard, smelled, touched, or tasted. So we can only feel that. Okay, it is a feeling that comes under abstract noun. So we will see examples, then you will get to know. So examples are laughter, sorrow, joy, pride, shame, loyalty, and health. So laughter is a feeling, okay, that we experience. So it comes under abstract noun. Sorrow means unhappy. Okay, so it is also abstract noun because we cannot touch that. Okay, it is our feeling. Joy is also our feeling, happiness. Okay, pride is also a feeling, okay, that we experience. Shame, loyalty is quality of any person. Okay, so it comes under abstract noun. It is a quality. And health. And here are some abstract nouns. Okay, you have to remember that. Which are they? Kindness, darkness, honesty. Honesty is a quality of person. Wisdom, slavery, policy. Okay, innocence. Innocence is also quality of someone. Okay, poverty, prosperity, love, hatred, judgment, growth, strength, gravity, loyalty, royalty, spirit. Okay, freedom, courage, bravery, luck, justice, happiness, anger, humility. So all the words, okay, mentioned here are the abstract nouns. Why? Because we can feel that, okay, or we can experience that feeling, but we cannot touch that, okay, or we cannot taste that, smell that. Okay, it is only a feeling, so it comes under abstract noun. So what we have seen, learned till now, that noun, what are nouns? Its types: concrete noun and abstract nouns. Concrete nouns are the name of things that we can touch, smell, okay, taste, see, hear. Okay, and abstract nouns are the nouns which we cannot taste, smell, okay, or touch, and we can only feel that or experience that. And concrete noun is subdivided into proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. And we have seen that in detail. So this is all about the noun and its kinds. Okay? Thank you.